Many people are coming to church in the last part of this year. In this month, December alone, it has been recorded that church attendance is going on a rise. Is it because the year is coming to an end? Is it because more people are transforming their lives? Or is it just because it's something that is done all the time? For now, we are seeing that in most churches, especially those in the city, the attendance is coming on the rise in this month of December. Whilst this is not surprising to us, some people find it shocking because after the pandemic, there was some decrease in, you know, church attendance. But even a year after last year like this, even though it had, you know, come down a little bit, there were still many people who, you know, preferred to do it online, and others who even had completely stopped going to church. So this year there were a few numbers going up in some places. Some churches were still low with church attendance, but this December things have just taken a radical turn. In almost all the churches, many people are, you know, are coming. And there are some people who are wondering why especially this month of December, this last month, are they coming? Now, there have been several reasons given for this. Some people claim this is the time those who don't normally go to church come to church, so that at least the Lord will see that though they've not been around the last of the year, they've come, so they can at least come and say hi to God and then go back to do their things they've been doing. Then when next year comes, to the same thing, they'll wait when December comes before they go to church. January, February, March, they'll not appear. April, May, June, you'll not see them. July, August, September, you'll call them, they'll not come. Then November, they'll promise you, then December, they'll be there. So this is for one group of people. There are just some people who they are not really into this going to church, and they have their own reasons. Some people believe that the Christian work is not about going to church, so because of that, they don't want to even bother themselves getting to the church. And there are others who believe the real church is the one that you do in your house, the one that you do when you meet somebody who offends you, the way you behave with others, that is a real church. So some people don't really like church. Then there are also those people who don't come to church because they don't trust some of the church people, you know. They don't trust some of the pastors, they don't trust some of the heads of these churches, because maybe they've heard or seen one thing or the other which sounds or seems corrupt to them. So when they realize that, for example, a certain pastor was doing something that they have judged as a wrong thing, they don't trust that would be a place where they can get their spiritual food. So many people don't really like to go to church because of this, because the trust for their pastors is, for those pastors, are not around. So what they do is that they don't even want to go to any church at all. When it's around December, at this time, it's they have to at least appear before God. So they just come and show their faces, you know, wish a Merry Christmas, and then they go. The next year, the same thing happens. So there are also those who don't go to church because, you know, they've seen things and heard things about the church and they are not happy about. But that's not the only reason given for the, you know, the low attendance of church from the beginning of the year until now. Then when it's December, people go. And people also claim people are not going to church because of the fear of contracting this pandemic, this virus, and all the noises that are being made around variants, virus, and all these volatile, you know, diseases and outbreaks. So because, you know, sometimes when you're in church, depending on the church you go to, they are close, you know, you get close to people. Sometimes they'll tell you, shake your neighbor, say hi and all of those things. So because of all this closeness to some people, those who are afraid of getting this virus are not even going to dare to, you know, present themselves in the church places. But for these people, there's something I'm wondering, because if they are really afraid of getting the virus, then where else would they go when they are not able to get healed of a certain different disease or virus? Because to the best of our knowledge, the church is actually the place where when people get sick and people have certain diseases that even the doctors cannot cure, the church brings that healing through the, you know, mighty works of God, through prophets, pastors, bishops, men of God, and all these types of people who work in the house of the Lord. So I'm just wondering if people are afraid to go to church because of getting this virus or disease, then that means they should not even go anywhere else. The marketplaces, they should not be there. The restaurants, they should not be there. The supermarkets, they should not be there. The schools, they should not be there. Because in all these places, the church is the only place where healing is guaranteed and assured. Sometimes you go to church, you don't even have to, they don't even have to necessarily do a healing, you know, service. But as you're in the church and you're listening to, you know, the word of God and enjoying the sound of the beautiful gospel songs, your spirit gets revived, and sometimes the disease that came with you, it vanishes. By the time you leave the church, you realize that you're a completely different person. So for those who are afraid of going to church, you know, because of this virus variant and all the other names they are calling them, please, unless maybe the church you are going to is not a real church of God. But if it's a church of God, I don't think you can go and contract diseases there. That's the place that they take diseases away. So you can't just go there and go and receive a disease. We've not heard of it before that in the ministry of Jesus or any of the apostles, somebody went for fellowship and went to receive a disease or a sickness. It has never happened before. So for those, this is just for those who are not going to church due to the fear of getting the virus and all of these you know, pandemic things that have been going on. Now there are also those who they are not really churchgoers or necessarily people who are passionate about these things, but they just feel like it is necessary to pass through church at the last time of the year. So these people to also add to the number of people who come to church, and then also they make the church attendance increase. And then there are those who also who go to church at this time because they want to see certain people's faces and they want to meet certain people. Yes, there are people like that. So when they mentioned it, I was not surprised. You know, there are some people, they only go to church because they want to see the dress that a certain sister wore, or they want to see the dress, the makeup, and the handbag that a certain a woman is going to bring on a certain, you know, Sunday service. So when it comes to this time like this, they are always there. There are people who also only go to church because they want to see a friend or someone who they admire. And this is the time that normally those people who have probably been in schools which have been far away from the church, so they cannot go, will now be returning to these churches because now it's December and they've been released. Also, maybe those people who have traveled to places where, you know, they can't come to the church anymore, this is the time where they can come back after being released. Maybe if it is their job or whatever it is that they are doing, at this time in December they are free. So all these people also come to church during the month of December. You know, they populate the place and increase the church attendance during this time of the year. Now some analysts are saying that we should take note of all those who have come to church this month, and we should take note of January and February to see if we'll see those same people in the churches again. They're asking us to do this because they believe these people are the once in a while church pass buyers. So it's not really because they came to serve the Lord or worship, but you know, they are just following religion. It's a thing that many people go after blindly. And in a way, I understand what they are saying. There are some people who, they don't really come to church because they want to worship. You know how sometimes you just want to worship, you just want to be in the atmosphere of the Lord. You just want to enjoy the music from the choir. You just want to listen to a word from the bishop. You know, sometimes you just, it's just inside of you. So even when you are not able to go to church, you, wherever you are, you find yourself singing or worshiping or just doing something to get close to the Lord, maybe reading your Bible or something. Yeah, but there are some people, they really don't see that worship as the reason why they come to church. They see church as a place of a gathering, like a place where, you know, I can come and meet my old classmates and we talk about some things we heard, you know, like we share some experiences. Yeah, that's how they see church. Yeah, so like there are these religious people who are also coming to the churches during this month, and so are increasing the attendance of the church. But the good thing is, all in all, this year the church attendance has been on the rise when you compare it to last year and then 2019. Especially 2019, the church attendance was poor. There were some churches that were completely empty. It was just amazing. We never thought we'd see anything like this. Imagine that the whole church, a place where, you know, the fear of the Lord is a place where we hold in high esteem and all. Because of this pandemic that came about, many churches were empty. So looking back at 2019 and looking now at this year 2021, we feel it's a step up. We have seen some goodness. There's more and more people coming. And hopefully all those people who are coming, they'll be receiving what the Lord has for them, and it will not just be about socialization and all these reasons why people come to church. Some people do only time a certain brother, when they know a certain brother Mark, a very good looking brother Mark, maybe he'll be at church in December. So that's the time that they'll dress well, they'll dress very, very well. When we say dress well, you understand, then they'll come so that they can just get a chance to speak to Brother Mark, so that Brother Mark will look at their clothes as they turn around and behave like, you know. Yeah, so everybody has their reason why they go to church, but you cannot judge anybody. At the end of the day, they've come to the church. It is God who judges. The most important thing is that as they come, one way or the other, they'll receive the word of God, and also they'll be in the atmosphere of worship. Those are very important things, so that even though maybe that's not their main reason of coming there, they have become a part of it. They are partaking of it, especially with the word. They'll be listening to it. Maybe their attention may not be there, but one word will touch them, and it will open their eyes to see things differently. You know, people are following after Jesus passionately, but there are those who also don't understand who Jesus is. They just see it as a story. They just see Jesus as just one of those names that Christians use. So they just come to church and then go. But if you really want to notice those who are passionate about Jesus, you know it is not only in December that they'll come. And then there are those who also are very passionate, are very true worshippers, but because of some certain circumstances surrounding them, they are not able to come to the church. It's not because they don't want to come, but because there are certain you know, things beyond their control, so they are not able to make it during the year. So all in all these have been factors why church attendance has been on the decline this few, you know, months so far. But hopefully 2022 and, you know, and going, we'll see more and more people attend our churches. Yeah, it's very necessary. We have to worship God. Look, many people were not able to survive this pandemic, but you are still here. The fact that you are even listening to this alone means that the grace of the Lord God has come upon you. So you've been favored, you've been shown mercy. So for those of you who are not going to church, please try your best and go to church. Okay, so you can leave your comments in the section below and let us know the reason why you think people don't come to church until it's December. And then let us know also what you think is the best way to go about this. Thank you very much for listening and have a nice day.